Hi, welcome to How to Repair. In this tutorial I'll be showing you how to use Ohm's law to test elements in multiple ways. You can either use the Ohm's resistance value to test the wattage of the element, or you could use the wattage of the element to understand what the resistance should be to test the elements. On some occasions, if you have a test bay or a test meter, you're also able to use the amperage that the appliance is drawing to understand what values the resistance should be on the elements or the wattage. Now, we've got a dissected oven here that I use for demonstrations. And firstly, you need to know the combinations of the elements within the oven. Now, on fan oven setting, you would be using a fan oven element in conjunction with the fan motor that distributes the air around the oven. On a convection oven, you would be using a combination of part of the grille element used with the base element, which is situated in the cavity below the oven, which is not normally visible to people when they're trying to understand the faults with the oven. Now, if you're trying to find faults on an oven, there is a playlist in the description below on all different procedures for testing ovens for different faults. But we're just dealing with Ohm's law, and I'm going to show you how to test elements using the calculator, which is also in the description below.
For those of you who have never used an Ohm's law calculator before, let me quickly show you the three ways in which I use it. You always need a base voltage. So we are testing at 230 volts, which is stamped on all the elements. Although we live in the United Kingdom and we're drawing 240 volts, our voltage does vary between 230 and say 240. So we're using 230 volts. You must also fill in one of these other three fields. Let me give you three examples. We will be testing an 1800 watt element later. So if we put in 1800 watt, we know that the Ohm's resistance should be 29.38 Ohm's resistance on this element, allowing for 10 to 15% margin in error on the multimeter and also the age of the element. The second way that I use this is I also use it to work out the actual resistance, to work out what the wattage is. Now, I will be testing a base element later, but when I tested the element, I knew that I had 63.7 ohms resistance, but I did not know the wattage at the time. So when I press calculate, it is telling me I should be looking for 830 watts that the element will be drawing. Now, the element that we were testing was 850 watts. This is showing me that the element was in the 10 to 15% margin, which I'm talking about. The third way I use it, and this is really only for engineers that have a test bay. When I'm actually turning the oven on to fan oven element, when the fan is running, the timer is on, and there's a little red neon bulb that lights up next to the thermostat, I'd want to know what the combined power is. So, for example, if I know that the cooker is drawing 8.7 amps, this then tells me that the combined wattage that is being drawn by the appliance is 2001 watts. I would be able to work out that the element is 1800 watts thereabouts. The neon light, the timer, and the fan motor is drawing 201 watts altogether. Those would be the type of numbers which I would expect when testing a cooker. I hope this helps you. We'll now move on to testing the individual components within the cooker.
Right, the first element we'll test is the most common element to fail on all cookers, whether you have a freestanding cooker, a built-in cooker, or a range cooker. Fan oven elements are the most common element. Now, this element has actually got stamped on it, 230 volts, 1800 watt. It is situated in the rear of the cooker, and a fan motor circulates the air from this element around the cooker, and a thermostat at the top controls the element, turning it on or off. On more modern cookers, you have NTC sensors and a circuit board that control this, and sometimes the relays can fail. But we need to understand the three ways of testing this element. Now, if we put it on to Ohms reading on the multimeter and we get a good connection across the element, we can see that we have a reading of 29.8 ohms. This then can be entered into the calculator, which would tell us what the wattage is that you can see here. Now, as long as you're within 10 to 15%, the element is good. And we know that we have a resistance value and we have an ohms reading at the calculator, which is telling us the rough wattage of the element. Two things to be aware of when checking with Ohm's law. One, you only need to be within 10 to 15%. The reason being is not all people will have calibrated instruments to be able to test exactly. And elements wear slightly over the period of time and the resistance value may change slightly. But as long as you're within 10 to 15%, you know this element is good. Okay, now we'll deal with grille elements. And as I said earlier, convection ovens will use part of the grille element or all of the grille element in conjunction with the base element to create the convection oven. Now we have a single grille element here and this is 230 volts to 2000 watts. And if we do an ohms reading on this element, we have 26.5 ohms reading. Now that tells me that the wattage on this element is 2 kilowatt or 2000 watts. Now with the dual grille element, you have two circuits, an inner circuit and an outer circuit. Now conventionally, the outer circuit is used in conjunction with the base element with convection ovens. Different manufacturers do different combinations, so it does vary. But if the thermostat, when the selector switch is set to convection oven, it will be sending electricity to the outer part of this element and also to the base oven element. So if we do a couple of readings on this element, and this element does have stamped on it 900 watt and 1300 watt at 230 volt. So that means that we have two circuits. The inner part of the element, which is a bigger area, is the 1300 watt, and the outer part is the 900 watt. And we're able to test this with ohms reading, making sure that we've got a good connection. And the outer circuit has a reading of 59.6. And that tells me that it's 900 watts. If we test the inner part of the element, we have a reading of 40.4. And this tells me that the inner part of the element is 1300 watt. Now, when using this in conjunction with the base element, now the base element is stated on the plate that it's 850 watts. And the manufacturer may be using the combination of the either the inner circuit on the dual grille element with the base element. So we'd have 1300 watts plus the 850 would give us a combined drawing power of 2150 watts, which would be drawing somewhere in the region of 910 amp. And we're able to test the base element exactly the same. And the base element, we have got 63.7, and that tells me that the base element is also good, and we have a reading of 850 watts. Now, the two main reason elements fail. Either they're open circuit, meaning that there's electricity going to the element, but no power is being drawn. This means that no heat will occur in any way, shape or form from that element. And if you were using a convection oven, you may have the grille element is in good condition and working, but the base element is faulty. This means that the food would be burning at the top, but not cooking underneath very well. Or we might have an opposite scenario where the base element was good, but the outer circuit of the grille element is not working, and therefore the food is cooking on the underside, but not burning at the top. a lot of people have this problem, especially when they are professional, well, not professional, but people that do a lot of cooking, when it comes to cooking pies, pastry and so on, their pastry isn't rising, and that's because they may have a fault on one of the elements. So that covers that type of fault. The other fault is when you have earth leakage. Earth leakage you can see in one of the other videos below in the description, and this means that the element is tripping the electricity supply. This is a different fault completely. The element would have a good reading, but it is tripping the electrical supply. And this is because electricity is tracking from the inner part of the element to the outer part of the element. As you can see on this dissected element that I have here, the inner part is the filament or the element. The outer part is the casing that is connected to the earthing system on the cooker. If the inner part is tracking through the silicon to the outer part in any way above 30 milliamp standard, your RCD will trip on the electricity supply, and that is a separate fault altogether. You will find this in the playlist below in the description on how to actually find the fault with your cooker. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please remember to subscribe to the channel, as that's what keeps us going and able to make these videos for you. And if you do need any elements for your cooker, please visit the website, enter your full model number in, and we should be able to find the part for you. If we can't, then please contact us at the website using your full model number and serial number off your cooker, and we'll be happy to help you.